home foods, getting ready to make some dishes for our game day that's coming up. And Michaela is next, going to be teaching us about chili.
Yeah, that's right. We make a great meatless chili at home. So basically, Mary, if you just want to put a little bit of oil in your pot, you're going to cook everything in the same pot, which is the best part.
That makes it easy.
Exactly. And then I've chopped up one whole onion. So you're going to put that in, you're going to put it on the stove around like medium to medium high heat. And basically you just want to cook up these onions, just, you know, have them brown a little bit. Yep, exactly. And now you're going to add your tomatoes. We have four different kinds of tomatoes. So you're going to add whole tomatoes.
I love whole tomatoes.
Me too.
You know, I really do. I love
Some people don't love them
they don't
as
like the consistency.
Big.
Yeah.
So I like to even just kind of give them a little smush,
right.
Just so that way it helps break them up in there. And Mary, you're going to add tomato sauce, stewed tomatoes, and diced tomatoes. Just so that way you get a good variety.
Of
different sizes, exactly, exactly, and this will serve as your base. So you're gonna let this sit, and you're gonna let it thicken up just for a little bit. And now there aren't too many measurements. This is also where you would add meat.
Okay.
If you want to add ground meat or ground turkey, we're using 5 cans of beans because this is where the heartiness comes in because we're not cooking with meat. So you're going to add 2 cans of kidney beans. I like to use the dark red kidney beans, but you can really use whatever you prefer. Then we're going to add 2 cans of cannellini beans.
Love those.
The white beans.
Okay, there you go.
And then 1 can of garbanzo beans or chickpeas, whatever you like to call it. I call them chickpeas in my house. And you can also add corn to this. You can add any other type.
I think it looks great just like
bean.
This.
Exactly. And this is like the heartiness. It has good proteins in it. We have a little salt and pepper. We have some garlic powder. And like I said, measurements are however you want. The best thing about chili is that it can just sit on the stove all day long, pretty much.
Sometimes it tastes better like that.
Exactly. And if you leave the top off of it, it'll thicken up better. We have a finished one here. So, Will, if you want to kind of scoop that into a bowl.
Right.
And
grab this.
I have some bread here. I love having bread with chili. And you can either just get the slices, or sometimes what I like to do is just cut them into thick pieces, throw a little bit of olive oil on them, and throw them in the oven, and you kind of have like a homemade crouton, and then you can sprinkle those pieces into the chili. I don't know if you like chives, There you go, a little cheese for me.
So colorful.
And like your recipe the other day, Will, is that you can just have this the next day.
And it's still good.
It's still good.
Still good.
So, guys, you wouldn't even know there wasn't meat in it. You know who really loves meat?
Right.
Don't miss it.
Go Pats.
These are great.
Hey, there we go.
Cheers.